These T.D. Jakes and these Eddie Long, God is allowing this to happen for one reason only. He's going to prove his righteous church.
Amen.
We're not going to be crowded. We're not going to have a whole lot. But he's going to have somebody who's going to stand up and defend the faith. Somebody's going to be holy.
Amen.
Somebody's going to, who's going to be like.
Yeah.
What in the world, these preachers, and I hear them all the time, all you got to do is confess Jesus as your Lord and Savior, and you're saved. It makes no difference what you've done, how you, it makes a difference what you do after the fact. Now, what you've done before the fact of salvation, no, it don't make no difference. But after you've been converted, you got to do something. You've got to renew your mind and be acceptable in the sight of God by living a holy and sanctified life in this present world. And that's the Bible. Why won't you preachers read that part?
Amen.
You read Romans 10 and wear it out. 10 and 10, you'll wear it out. Give me Romans 8 chapter.
Amen.
Verse 1.
There is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in the flesh, but there is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit.
Who walk not after the flesh. Who don't live according to the common life, but live now according to the Spirit. And verse 7.
Because the carnal mind is enmity against God.
The flesh is an enemy of God.
For it is not subject to the law of God.
The flesh is not going to serve the law of God. Now, why is it that people will support Eddie Long, support T.D. Jakes, when the Bible says that they who live in the flesh, it's impossible for them to please God?
Amen.
They're enemies of God. Verse 8.
So then they that are in the flesh cannot please God. But ye are not in the flesh, but in the Spirit.
Now, twofold here. He's identifying those who are in the flesh and those who are in the Spirit. But he says to the church, you are not in the flesh, you're in the Spirit. Verse 9.
But ye are not in the flesh, but in the Spirit. If so be that the Spirit of God dwell in you.
If so be that the Spirit of God dwell in you.
Now if any man have not the Spirit of Christ, he is not of him.
Now let's connect that with 1 Corinthians chapter 3.
Amen.
Verse 17.
If any man defile the temple of God, him shall God destroy. For the temple of God is holy, which temple ye are.
Now when the Holy Ghost comes to indwell, that makes you a property of God, and your body now becomes the temple of the living God. Now it says, if any man defile, in other words, and if you corrupt through a sinful lifestyle, any man defile the temple of God, him shall what?
God destroy.
Now, Mr. Pearson, I don't know what you're talking about. You don't even know hell. I don't care what you call it, but the Bible says he's going to destroy it.
Amen.
And do you know, again, I heard a preacher over the radio saying, and he tried to identify the scripture. He says, now once you get to heaven, there are certain ones going to get rewards, and there are certain ones that are not going to be rewarded when you get to heaven. Now I want you, preacher, I want you to show me that scripture. You email me, prophetwalker@windstream.net. It's on the YouTube. Email me and show me that scripture where when you get to heaven, there is a reward for them who don't do good, and there's another reward for them that do good.
Amen.
But the Bible says the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of heaven.
Amen.
Now, what you going to do with that scripture?
Verse
18. I'm in 3 and 18, 1 Corinthians.
Let no man deceive himself. If any man among you seeming to be wise in this world, let him become a fool that he may be wise.
If you wise, it'd be better that you act like you're a fool.
Amen.
So that you can be blessed and go to heaven.
Amen.
But any time you are so wise till you can't see the decency code that God has, then you actually have gotten too wise.
Right.
You got so wise you made yourself a fool.
Right, Bob.
You cannot destroy the Word of God, because the Word of God is set forth for a reason, and that's to establish a credit of character among the people who truly seek after righteousness. And you cannot make sin right in the sight of God because of something God did at Calvary. He died that we might have another life. That's true. But after he died, he told us what to do to have another life.
Yes. Amen.
And how can someone go against that? Where people, you're going for everything. Where True Light is trying to identify and show you a different pathway. And that's the correct pathway. That's the pathway that's not being taught today. And the reason why, there's too many weak-kneed creatures, cowardly members who will support anything and anybody. Don't examine their lifestyle. Don't examine their character. Just support anything. How can you be like that?
Amen.
When your soul salvation is at stake. All right, we're going to call our panel up. Elder Lancy, Elder Willis, Minister Marshall, Elder Ricky. I mean, we've got four there. We're going to have... Elder Brooks be the moderator. Have we got the panel? Start with all. Elder Willis.
Praise the Lord, saints.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, saints.
Praise the Lord,
saints. All honor to my Lord Jesus Christ, the head of my life. Give all honor, and all honor to our end time apostle and prophet, Prophet Ace Walker, and the Lady Elect. Hallelujah. We give all the honors due this day, glory to God. It's been a wonderful day in the name of Jesus this day. Hallelujah. Just thank you for waking me up this morning, glory to God. Hallelujah. See another wonderful day. And, you know, Prophet was talking about the false prophets and those that. Really just on television for more, no more than just money makers and people just really making light of the gospels. And, you know, I've come to find out over the years, just kind of, I don't watch them, but every now and then I'll kind of get on the internet and look and see what one of them had to say. And, you know, I watched progressively over the years. You know, I used to, I don't know, 20, 25 years ago, when there wasn't very many stations around and you could turn to a pastor, he might be pulling a little bit of his word out of the Bible, or he might be, but, you know, nowadays, my goodness, they might talk 20 or 30 minutes and never even touch the Bible. It's all talking about wealth, and, you know, I heard one not too long ago said it is children are known by their cars that they drive around town. Hallelujah. One got a Mercedes, some kind of Mercedes where the, you know, the doors open up on the, you know, up on the, I think it's called a gold wing or whatever they call that, and, you know, I was just thinking about the riches that they gather, you know. God never told a preacher to go out and collect all the money for himself. Hallelujah. I believe he told the preachers to not worry about taking money, not worry about taking clothes. Just go out and preach the gospel. Hallelujah. Freely have you have received, freely give. Glory to God. So, you know, the pastors nowadays, they want to bring all the riches to them that they can bring to themselves. But, you know, I just got to thinking about that today and kind of meditating on it and how all the... I guess most people call it. I call it the prosperity preaching, but I don't know what they call it. But you know, I just got to think about that today. How they support one another, and how they have this big, seem like a big support line, you know. And one of them seem like they're going to fall from their church or fall from leadership, and another one to come and support them. Hallelujah. And this Carlton Pearson, I noticed he wants to support Mr. Eddie Long. And Carlton Pearson, I don't know if you know it or not, but he used to be a Church of God in Christ minister. And I don't know, he might have been a bishop there. But, you know, he left the organization and became a bishop in a Unitarian belief. And that Unitarian belief preaches the gospel of inclusion. And that means that if you're a Muslim or a Hindu or Jew or homosexual, you all have a place in the heavenly kingdom. That's what the prophet was talking about earlier. Some people believe you get blessed a little bit more than others, but you all make it in there. And that's called the gospel of inclusion. But I can't find inclusion anywhere in the Word of God. Hallelujah. I found a judgment in the Word of God. But I don't find inclusion. Hallelujah. So I want to know what Bible you're reading from, Mr. Pearson. Glory to God. I want to know what Bible that you're getting your information from. Because you can't be getting it from the same Bible I get mine from, which is the King James Version Bible, the only Bible that you're supposed to read, glory to God. Amen. So I want to know where you're getting your information from. Hallelujah. Yeah. Glory to God.